everyone, and welcome. Well, today we are not on Secrets of a Victorious Mind. I'm here because there was a live chat planned with TechFest IIT Bombay, and I was here to launch the initiative towards the awareness of breast cancer. And unfortunately, I couldn't log on to their account, so hopefully now they'll join me. They'll send me a request and then we'll add each other, and then it'll be as good as me being on their live. They'll be on mine. Okay, let me have a look at the request and we accept.
God, it was... Oh, finally. Hi, Doc. How are you?
Yes. Finally. Most welcome.
Thank you. I don't know what happened. I've been sending continuous requests, but I guess you were not able to accept it, or somebody from TechFest was not probably enabling the accepting of the request. I don't know what it was, but a big sorry to all the people watching, waiting, and sorry to you, you know, for this whole technical error, whoever's mistake it was. And thank you for the lovely introduction that you gave me earlier and all the lovely things that you said.
Yeah, and I think, you know, I had to go on and on about breast cancer, and I'm really sorry to the viewers, and I again really want to welcome you, and really want to thank you, because I know you are, you know, such a beautiful, pretty, talented, multi-talented, you know, celebrity, and with your kind of fan following of more than 4.4 million people, I'm sure you can do wonders to this initiative. In fact,
thank
I've spoken
you.
So much
about it.
I really want to hear it from you, that what are your views about breast cancer in our country, you know, being the most common cancer, and what do you think about breast cancer in our country, and how, what we can do to actually prevent it?
Yeah, so breast cancer is one of the most common cancers that affect women. In fact, you know, 14% of all Indian women that have cancer happen to have breast cancer. And like you were saying, every one in eight women, you know, tend to have, one in 28 women tend to have breast cancer. I think it's a very sad situation that not enough people are proactive about getting screened and doing their self-diagnosis and doing their breast examinations, whether at home or whether going to, you know, a screening facility where they can have a mammogram. So I'm really, really so happy that TechFest IIT Bombay has come up with this initiative towards breast cancer awareness. Because most of the times we have always, but in the past we've always overlooked health, and you don't expect a TechFest to be giving so much importance to health. So I think I would like to first acknowledge and appreciate, you know, the entire initiative by TechFest IIT Bombay and their entire team. And I think this pandemic has also really urged us to realize the importance of health, as it's not just about our well-being. It's the entire economy of our country also depends on our health, right? And our entire well-being and health, yeah.
Yeah, very true. You know, Corona has actually brought the concept of prevention. You know, we know that we are wearing masks, we are getting vaccinated, and we are talking about hand washing. We are talking about everything in prevention. And again, so far, you know, the women's cancers are concerned. I'm a great proponent. I always say prevention is better than cure. Instead of getting into the mess, once a woman in the family gets cancer, the whole family gets disturbed.
I know.
Women are the pillars. Pillar of the family's health. So, you know, I also feel proud to be a part of Nidan, an initiative by IIT Mumbai, where they've associated with Cancer Tech Foundation and a lot of other NGOs. And just to update you that, you know, during this coming week, we'll be working on this initiative called Nidan, where we'll be actually training a lot of healthcare workers, you know, because so many times they only know about vaccination, they know how to initiate breastfeeding, but they don't know other things about women's health. Women's health does not end at giving birth. You know, we should not think that now that you are a mother, you don't need to visit the doctor. So here comes the role of those ASHA workers and those Anganwadi workers and ANMs to actually motivate women to do their breast self-examination. So we'll be training, you know, we have around about 6 training sessions with the government. With the help of IIT Mumbai Nidan Initiative, there will be training the ASHA workers, and we have about 12 sessions for colleges all over the country, where
That's
we'll be
fantastic.
motivating a lot of young yeah we'll be motivating a lot of young women to understand the concept of screening. So here again, because Aarti, you are I can see that you are very fit, and of course, your site also shows that you're doing a lot of talks regarding the wellness and the holistic attitude towards health. So what you think should be the way to deal with the increasing incidence of cancer in our country?
Well, like you said, prevention is better than cure. And of course, a stitch in time saves nine. So, I think after the age of 30, 35, please correct me if I'm wrong, you're an authority on this. You must get yourself checked regularly, and you should have, time slots that are fixed every, how often, every year that you get at least a mammogram or something. How often do you suggest it, doc?
See, after the age of 35, you should have a mammogram. And if your mammo is normal, you can actually do it once in 3 years. But if you're one of those high-risk patients that, you're...
Where you've had cancer in the family or...
Or your mammogram last year was abnormal, then you probably need more frequent screening depending upon how your doctor actually guides you.
Absolutely. And actually being observant when you are, probably having a bath, you take a good look at yourself in the mirror, all the women. And it's very important to examine yourself and look at yourself. We tend to just look at our face. Okay, we're ready. Chalo, out of there. Spend that time with yourself. Look at yourself. See if there's something that looks abnormal. If there's a lump, if there are scales, if there's some orange, something that looks uneven or doesn't look normal to you. Make sure that you report it to a doctor and do not ignore these signs, because the universe and, God or whatever the power above that you have has a way of sending you certain signals and it whispers to you. But what happens is we don't listen to those whispers. And then we have to wake up when life actually starts knocking and banging on the door and saying, damn, now you need to do something about your health. So don't wait until it blows out of proportion and listen to the little whispers. Be more observant and present, in your daily, day-to-day life, so that you notice if there's anything that's amiss with your body, with your mind, with your health. And then, you can prevent something bad from happening. Because again, correct me if I'm wrong, most breast cancer patients that are diagnosed of breast cancer come to know when they're already in the third or fourth stage, right?
Absolutely.
Yeah. And if they were to come to know much earlier, then they would have been able to do something about it and cure themselves. And the survival rate and the recovery rate is only up to 60% in India. Is that so?
Yeah, very true.
Yeah.
Yeah. And you've brought up such a beautiful point that, the beauty is in health. It does not end with the beauty of the face. So you need to give that 10 minutes in 1 month. 10 minutes in 1 month is like nothing, You just require those 10 minutes to do your breast health examination. And if you don't touch your breast because of all, excuses people give me, I don't have time, I'm scared, I feel shy. My mother told me if you touch your breast, you get breast cancer. If you touch your breast, your lumps will form. So people have all kind of myths. So breast health examination is must for all women. It needs to be done only once a month. And as RTG has rightly pointed out, that if you have any lump, if you feel any change in the shape of the breast, if you notice any kind of secretion from your nipple, whether it is red, whether it is white, or it is watery in color, if there's any kind of, dimpling around the nipple, or if you see that the texture of the skin is changing, it's not smooth, it appears like a orangish kind of a, dimpling is there, or small holes appear in the breast skin, you must report to the doctor. And as I was saying, don't be scared. If your breast cancer is diagnosed in first stage, there is 80 to 90% of chance that it will be fully cured. The problem starts when we are diagnosing almost 80% of our cancers, breast cancers and all other cancers in third and fourth stage. Even in the best of the hands, even in the best of the centers, the survival actually depends upon the stage. So early diagnosis is the key to successful treatment. And how will you diagnose early? You're not going to touch your breast. That taboo has to has to get away, you know. Breast is also a part of our body. You can't say that I'll touch my arm, I'll touch my face, but I will not touch my breast. So I think this is a very important message from your side. I really love that word, that it's not that just get ready and, you know, get your face ready and give that 10 minutes a month to also the breast examination. So, you know, as we are already saying that there's a lot of lack of awareness in the society. So about, you know, how to prevent cancers. So what is your message, Aarti, to your audience? You know, you have got such a huge fan following, and I'm also one of them. You know,
so sweet. But, thank you.
You are intelligent, brilliant, creative, actor, producer, you know, dancer. You've got a lot of feathers to your cap. So what is your message to the audience?
Firstly, thank you so much for all the appreciation. I am absolutely honored and privileged to be on this chat with you and be supporting Nidan and TechFest IIT Bombay towards this breast cancer awareness initiative. Well, apart from being aware and keeping your eyes open and being very present with yourself on a day-to-day basis, I would say there's this lovely book called You Can Heal Your Life, which is by Louis Hay. And it's been with me since many, many years. And she talks about how all diseases have their root in emotions, in the way we feel. So if it's your head, it relates to something. If it's your arm, it relates to something. If it's your gut, it relates to something. But if it's your breasts, it says that it relates to mothering, over-nurturing, and over-nourishing others, and ignoring yourself. So it's time that people, to prevent it as a preventive measure, give that attention to themselves rather than being overbearing on other people and taking care of others. So you need to learn to take care of yourself. And there's an affirmation for this. I don't know whether you believe in affirmations, but they've always worked for me. My standard affirmation for health when I'm not well is I am whole, perfect, strong, powerful, loving, harmonious, and happy. So I was looking in this book for one affirmation that is for people who fear breast cancer or, you know, see symptoms of things not being right in their mammogram or are suffering from breast cancer in whatever stage it might be. And there was a lovely affirmation which I would like to share with the audiences today. So that affirmation is, so basically an affirmation is a positive statement that you say when you're very calm and peaceful and you repeat it so that it goes deep into your subconscious and your body actually listens to those affirmations and reacts. It helps the healing process. And if you don't have it, it protects you from getting anything like that. It's like a mantra or like a how do you say? Let's just call it affirmation. Okay. So it is, I am important. I count. I now care for and nourish myself with love and joy. I allow others the freedom to be who they are. We are all safe and free. So for most people who actually try and control others and make everything right in their life, you know, your family, your siblings, your, you know, your friends or your work people, you're constantly trying to tell people how to correct it, how things will be better for them. But if you were to shift that attention to yourself and try and give that time to yourself where you spend that time meditating or doing pranayama or eating the right amount of vegetables and fruits, simple thing like vegetables and fruits, have a big bowl of fruits, have a big bowl of vegetables. It alkalizes your blood and your system. And it prevents you from not just breast cancer, but all kinds of cancers. And like you were talking about cervical cancer and, you know, people having HPV, which is the human papilloma virus. I think all these cancers come from being very stressed, you know, having an extra, you know, a very acidic kind of a blood type, right? Where we have a lot of acidity and a lot of, we need to alkalize ourselves. So I think meditation... Yeah, meditation, fruits, vegetables, and being present. This would be my advice from my holistic angle and, you know, what I love reading about, studying, and exploring. that these affirmations would help. Just before going to sleep, you say it every day to yourself. I am important. I count. I now care for and nourish myself with love and joy. I allow others the freedom to be who they are. We are all safe and free. Let go of, you know, trying to control others.
Those are beautiful words, and there's a very important hidden message that I am important. And I think every woman should consider that she is important and not think that, you know, I need to work for my mother-in-law, I need to work for my husband, for my children. And those are the kind of excuses women will give, you know, when they don't come for their checkups, that I don't have time, I'm, you know, busy with their family. So giving that 10 minutes for breast self-examination, and then once a year just going to the doctor for your regular checkup, doing your pap smear, going for your cervical cancer vaccination. And I think that responsibility also should be shared by your male partner, that yes, you know, there are a lot of women in India who do not have the resources, who are not in charge of their own health. So here I always you know, request the husbands and the brothers and the sons that, you know, when you're gifting something to your mom or to your, you know, daughter or to your sister, just think of her health first and think that how many women in India are dying of these two such preventable diseases like cervical cancer and breast cancer. So, you know, as the, what is your health tips? What is your, you know, you are so fit yourself. So you've already given a very nice holistic mantra, you know, and it's, I think every woman should have it written. I'm important. And so what are the health tips you would like to give to your audience?
Yes. So apart from getting a self-check, you know, whether it's getting a mammogram for your, to check anything with your breast, or getting a pap smear, you know, to do with HPV or anything to do with the cervix. Apart from that, with health, I would say pranayama, because breathing, just taking deep breaths makes you so present. It brings you back to the present moment. You know, if I ask you, are you breathing right now? You're not focusing on it. You're talking to me. So you're so involved in, you know, what's going on in your mind. But if you were to, for 1 second, just focus on your breathing, you'll realize you're probably crunching and, you know, you're stressing your shoulders and your neck. If you were to just release and just that much is something that relaxes and puts you into a very relaxed state. And if you were to do 10 of these deep breaths every day, like 4 times a day, I mean, you do it sometime in the morning, you're just doing your own thing, you're on the laptop, you're working, or you're going out there and doing whatever, just take 10 deep breaths. Whenever you remember, take those 10 deep breaths. And if you want to go one level more advanced, then of course do pranayama, which is anulom vilom. It's alternate nostril breathing. Kapalbhati, which is, you know, it's, you take a deep breath in and then you let go of the air. You can read about it online. Brahmari, which is like after taking a deep breath in. So there are 3-4 very lovely breathing techniques that pranayama covers. I mean, there are many types of breathing in pranayama, but these 3-4, like I mentioned, alternate nostril breathing, kapalbhati, brahmari, and just chanting om. These few, I think, are very, very prime for good health, balancing your chakras, balancing your entire energies, and alkalizing your system so that you stay away from stress, because stress is something that increases the acid levels in your body and makes you more open to having diseases, especially cancer. So I would say, if I have to just say one thing, I mean, I can say 10, but pranayama is prime. And apart from that, I would say spending time in nature, whether it is going to a beach, whether it is taking a walk in the forest, or just taking the route home where, you know, you're walking amongst trees and you're not just constantly in malls and at home where you're, you know, around concrete stuff, but you're amongst nature. That is something that really helps balance your stress levels, because nature has negative ions which actually cancel out the positive ions which stress gives out. So it's very, very beneficial for health. And I think these would be my two prime points, apart from, of course, exercising and walking and all of that. Yeah.
That's so, so beautifully put. And then, you know, you will not believe, Aarti, there are actually scientific studies which say that if we take history of, you know, 100 cancer patients, that if they've had, you know, some kind of a very traumatic and a very stressful event in their lives in last 5 years before they were actually diagnosed with cancer. Almost 20 to 30% of them would discuss about some kind of a very stressful or a traumatic event. So that is how those negative emotions or those negative hormones can actually, increase or start the process of cancer cell multiplication in the body. And as you have so rightly said, that's so simple as those, yoga and pranayama activities, which, we've all learned since our childhood and we have kind of forgotten them and then we are not practicing them. They would go a long way. And then, yes, beautifully put that, going back to nature, because de-stressing yourself is a very, very important thing. And thank you so much, Bharti. I'm so sorry we had some kind of a technical problem and we were not able to connect. And
nice.
And I'm really grateful that, and I'm so happy and so proud that, you are so aware and you know so much about breast cancer yourself. and I'm really proud about your initiative about holistic mental health also. And it would be great if we can keep associated, in our future endeavors with Nidan. And here I would just like to add that, simple activities like walking. And, there are a lot of elderly women who are always thinking, I can't go to the gym, I can't do this exercise. So I always tell my patients, just walk. Walking is one of those simplest exercises, even if you're 40, even if you're 60. Whatever steps you can take, don't have big targets of 5,000 or 10,000 steps. Whatever steps you can take, remaining active, keep doing regular exercises, maintaining ideal weight. Obesity is one of the highest risk factors for breast cancer. So any of us can get breast cancer, but then if we can maintain ideal weight, take healthy diet, do regular exercise, and of course, absolute no-no, to any form of tobacco and alcohol. That is really bad for Indian women. And another thing, I want to request all the mothers, continue breastfeeding. I have seen how in my hilly state, those village women have also started getting breast cancer. There were years when nobody in hills got breast cancer because women used to breastfeed. Stopping breastfeeding by Indian women has been one of the very important reason for increasing incidence of breast cancer. So I would also request that you from your platform, please encourage women to breastfeed. It's like Amrit for their baby. And to please promote our Can app. It is available free of cost on our on Google Play Store. Can app is also to be launched in a lot of regional languages. This time we are trying to translate it in Marathi, in Gujarati, and in a lot of other regional languages so that all the women can learn how to do breast self-examination from the privacy of their homes. So I would request you to also promote, Can app from your platform so that all women can learn how to do breast self-examination.
Absolutely. I will definitely do it. I think it's a very noble and a very honorable thing to do, to share this awareness. And it would add to my, my Victorious Mind Power initiative towards wellness and holistic well-being. Yeah, for sure. And I think that's why I just wanted to add, more people in the urban setting are getting breast cancer rather than rural because they're giving up on breastfeeding. They're probably shifting to the bottle. But whereas in rural India, they're sticking to breastfeeding and therefore the numbers are lesser. So we need to learn from rural India and actually make sure that we continue with breastfeeding when it happens, because that also is good for your baby and it protects you from the chances of getting diagnosed with breast cancer.
Yeah. So our age-old Indian ways of doing yoga, of walking, taking simple traditional diet with lots of
taking
fruits and greens.
Vitamin D.
Yes. Vitamin D is another very important factor, and pranayama, as you rightly put, and going back to nature is the key. And yes, I am important. I think that's the most important message from you. And Nidan, from the side of CanProtect Foundation, from Nidan, from IIT Mumbai Tech Test, I really want to thank you for giving your time. And I want to apologize to the viewers for a little bit of technical disturbance. Thank you
no
so
worries.
Much.
All goes well that ends well. See you. Bye-bye. Thanks.
Thank you.
Bye.